What's up, guys? Welcome back to the ViewBug channel. For those who are new, my name is Ace, and on this channel, we cover a wide range of topics in the photo and video space. And in this video, we are going to be covering the topic of presets. We are going to be jumping in Lightroom. I'm going to show you how to use presets, how to save them, and how to create them. So without further ado, let's go ahead and jump on the computer and get started. So first things first, you want to make sure that you're in your develop module in Lightroom. Now I've imported this photo here and we are under our develop module. This is what allows us to use presets, save presets, create presets, and just make overall edits to the image. So first things first, I want to show you how to actually create a preset. So let's say you have your image open and you want to make some adjustments. Let's go ahead and just make some quick adjustments here. I'm just going to increase the contrast. You can kind of see we're adding a little bit more tonal depth there. The highlights I'll bring down a little bit so we don't blow out her skin. And our shadows, oh, I'm going to also bring out quite a bit. There we go. I'm going to add a little bit of clarity here. Just like so. All right, let's say we've made our adjustments and we really like it and we want to save a preset. So a preset is basically a saved function of edits that you have already made. It makes it really easy for you to apply to a bunch of other images. And I'll show you actually right now how to save your preset. So on the left side, you have your preset panel. And if you click on this plus symbol here and then click create preset, it'll bring you to this dialog box. And you can go ahead and name your preset. You can put it in a specific group and you can actually select exactly the type of adjustments that you made. So this is helpful if you made a certain adjustment on your preset that you no longer want to save in here. This can be something as simple as your transform, or if you added maybe some grain or anything like that, that maybe you made just to that particular image, but you don't want to save it as a preset to add to a bunch of other images. That's more or less what this is for. So just for the sake of this example, I am going to name this preset tutorial and I'm going to save it to the group user presets. Go ahead and click on that. Now it's going to go ahead and save that. And I can scroll all the way down here to my own personal presets. And you can see right here, we have preset tutorial. So for the sake of this example, I'm going to actually just go over here, click reset. And you can see it's going to reset all our adjustments to zero. Now, if I hover my cursor over our preset here, you can see that it gives us a little preview. And if I wanted to enable all those settings to this image, I can simply left click. And you can see on our preset panel, or I'm sorry, on our editing panel here, it has added all our adjustments that we just made. So like I said, this is super useful, especially when you have a bunch of images down here in your timeline. You can literally just copy and paste this preset to all of them. Makes editing a lot of photos a very, very easy task. Now, another thing that I wanted to show you is Lightroom allows you to quickly preview presets by hovering your cursor over them. So right here I have user presets. These are just some of the ones that I've created from scratch. And if I hover my cursor over, it gives you a little preview of what it looks like. So again, this is also really, really cool and easy. So you know exactly what your image is gonna look like before having to actually click on it and have it add all those settings. Now, a fun tip that not a lot of people know is in your preset panel, if you hover and click over a particular preset, we'll use this one as our example. You click on that and you can see it's highlighted. If you then right click, it gives you a couple of more options. Let's say you've made some other adjustments and updated your preset a little more to your liking. What you can do is actually click on update with current settings, and it just makes it really quickly to update any minor adjustments that you may have made after you've already saved your preset. Another one that I use a lot is renaming the preset. So if I wanted to rename this, I can click on that and it'll bring up this dialog box and I can literally just type this, let's say rename. preset tutorial rename. Click on that, give it a second, and it will automatically rename that for you. Another option is you can move this to a different folder. As you can see here, I have it under the user presets folder, but if you wanted to put this in another folder that maybe may suit this edit a little bit better, you can do so. Now you can go ahead and click also show in Explorer, and this will basically show you the root directory of where that preset is located on your computer. This can be useful if you want to send it to somebody and just things like that. And of course you can delete or export it. And guys, that is gonna wrap up the video here. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, be sure to give it a thumbs up. It really does help the channel continue to grow. And if you're not subscribed already, guys, consider doing so. We have fresh content coming out for you every single week. Also, don't forget to hit that bell notification so you are notified as soon as a new video hits the channel. Now, with that said, thanks for watching, guys, and I will see you all in the next one.